Sometimes managing a business means that you put on lots of different hats. Maybe you're in charge of stock, maybe in charge of ordering, in charge of marketing, in charge of managing. Sometimes you just need to delegate. So Google My Business knows and understands that you can't always do everything. Sometimes helping others to take responsibilities off your shoulders can be really useful so you can focus yourself on what needs to be done in the business. Since doing these types of videos, I've had quite a few of you ask if I could manage your Google My Business listing for you. We can all specialize in one thing well, but sometimes we do need to delegate. For some, it makes sense that they do everything themselves, and video channels like this will help you to do that. But what happens if you do need to delegate? How do you give the control to someone else without losing the total control? Well, that's where users and managers' roles come into play on Google My Business. And on day 19, you may be feeling overwhelmed and you're now thinking of unloading this onto your web designer or onto someone else in your business that can run it for you. But you'll probably have the major concern, and if I give that information over, what stops them then taking over the business? What is there to make sure that I'm still the primary owner? Well, that's because user roles will always give the primary ownership to the person who registered the business. Unless you change ownership to another business, to someone else, you will always have the rights to give the management out, but also to take the management back. So understanding the roles will give you that peace of mind to know that you won't lose total control, even though you can give the majority of the delegation over to someone else. Richard Branson is a well-known English entrepreneur, businessman, and yet he says this. He says the art of delegation is absolutely key. If you think of the amount of businesses that Virgin own or Richard Branson was behind, no doubt he had to use a lot of delegation to get that type of success. But you notice he says it's an art. And sometimes with an art, you can't teach it. Sometimes you just have to gradually learn how to do something. So what type of questions should you be asking yourself as a small business owner today? Well, you'll be asking these questions such as, do you need to delegate or are you on top of it? Also, another question, is your time better spent elsewhere in the business? And for security reasons, have you checked, when was the last time you checked to make sure that you have the account users that you think you have? The fact is you may upgrade one or two people in the company and then gradually they may have left. So for security reasons, it'd be good to remove them if they don't need access. So let me show you now how you can change your users, how you can add users, how you can give them the different types of responsibilities and capabilities, and I'll explain what those differences are. So if I log into Google My Business, and if I then go to where it says users on the left-hand side, and there you'll see then I've got two ownerships here. I've got two accounts. So the primary owner, you see that's grayed out. And that means that whoever registered it, which obviously is me in this case, whoever's registered the business, that will never change. Google won't allow that to change. But what can change is you can add new users. So if I click add user, it will then just ask me what role I want them to be. And it will also ask me for their email address or their name. So I can punch in their name, their email address, I can choose which role. Now in a moment I'll go through what these roles are, but let's just go back to the role I've given myself on my other accounts, a different Gmail account here. And if I click on here, if I try to be primary owner, it will then ask me a bit more information about that. And that would be a case of transferring ownership. What's more likely is you want them to do everything that you can do as well. So you have a primary owner, but then the owner does everything as well. There's no difference at all. You could then cut it down to manager by doing that, or site manager. Of course, none of these changes take place until you click done. Well, let's just go over to Google and see what it is. So here you get the capabilities and what changes. So basically for the site manager, they get very little to do really. They can add attributes. They can do a few delivery links. They can add cover photos. They can respond to reviews. So they can't change things like the number, the telephone number, the services, the bulk of the stuff that's important, they can't do. So they can't change the ads, the messaging, the locations, but everything else can be changed if you're a manager. The only difference is they can't add or remove users. And then if you're the owner, you can do everything that the primary owner does as well. So those are the three things. So you probably want most people to be an owner. So I'd be interested to know, do you delegate? How many of you delegate? And if you do, do you actually get concerned about it? Does it work for you? What roles do you use when you delegate it out to other people? So put a comment down below. And I look forward to seeing your comments on that. Of course, while you're there, give this video a thumbs up so others can learn about this 30-day challenge. And in day 19, of course, we always like to ask ourselves to do a few more things or to think on a few more things. So what is it you're going to do today? Well, after this video is finished, go into your Google My Business and check to see how many users you have. Do you have the number of users that you expect to have? Secondly, do you need your web guy to update posts, blogs, and GMB to his list? It could be he's updating information on Twitter or Facebook. Why not get him also to log in and to put a Google My Business post at least once every 7 days? And that way then you'll get the benefit of being kept current in Google's algorithm. And finally, do you need to change the user type for those that you have enrolled in the past? Is it sufficient for what they need? Is it overempowering them? Well, that's something for you to check. But sometimes more is needed than just managing and empowering users. Sometimes you need someone to empathize with your clients or your customers and respond to their concerns. What do you do if you have an upset client? Well, tomorrow's lesson, day 20, you'll see how you can turn upset clients into happy customers using 4 methods that I use. I'll see you tomorrow.